So it's heavyweight then. And the word super heavyweight, I don't like that description. I think it means jumbo heavyweight. This is up to 14 stone 4 pounds, 91 kilos. And the Americans have got Riddick Bowe in tomorrow morning at the next higher weight, super heavies, which Terrell Biggs won in Los Angeles and remained unbeaten as a professional until he made the mistake of running into Mike Tyson. And Ray Mercer, 27-year-old, the veteran of the American team, a soldier stationed in Germany, he just popped over there and handed a little banner to the Koreans to say, listen, I know they haven't been too good to us, the Americans here, the crowd, but no hard feelings. The referee from Morocco, yeah, make sure you put the gum shield in, he says, it's obligatory. He's a bit ponderous, the Korean heavyweight, but Ray Mercer gets into a habit of having a little sleep halfway through the rounds if he's not careful, but he's a good puncher. He laboured against the Dutchman, Van der Ligi, I think that's how you say that, the European champion who just put out Britain's Henry Akinwande, who fought quite well, actually, in that final. It was a bit of a disappointing contest, not final, but contest, and just getting the rather enthusiastic photographers out of it. On the other hand, they've got to do their job, and the world and his brother want still pictures of this. And the chants of USA, USA, the coaches put their thumbs up, he's acknowledging them, Ray Mercer, and the last contest of this morning session then. And you see they're cheering those, and neither of those punches actually landed. Well, that one did. And so did that. So Mercer's got his own back, and he's a heavier puncher of the two. Now, he's come out firing this time, the soldier, isn't he? He's been laying about a little bit in some of the previous contests. Moroccan's got to have a bit of a strong control there, I suspect. He hooks him well. He dropped his arms a bit, Mercer, but he hooks like pro style for somebody I wouldn't have thought at 27 would bother about for Mercer boxing, really. He may, if he gets bought out of the services. And really, it all depends here. If you get a goal, he might be tempted to trade that for money. And the incessant chanting, which you would expect. It's everybody's hometown does this anyway with boxers, so there's nothing unusual in that. They certainly did it in Los Angeles. See, that's where I talk about Mercer taking his time. He doesn't have much respect for the opposition. He just stands in front of them, lowers the arms a bit, and just follows them around. He was looking for the target there, wasn't he, Ray Mercer, and this fella's not going to make it, and he's called it off. I thought he would. He looked like he was going to count to 10. He's gone raving mad, Mercer, and who can blame him? What confidence he came with. He took a few shots on the chin. He still had the time to do it, and he knew he could nail him. The American team and officials and the flags are waving in the arena. They really love to get their heavyweight winning, and I think it's more than their pride could have stood to have a Korean, the first one ever in the heavyweight finals of the Olympics. And he looked, just prior to taking that punch, as though he was face pulling a little bit, as he was there. He tended to do that as though nobody'd known the troubles he'd seen. and the lads from the team are all jumping up there, and there's kisses and cuddles all around. I mean, this is a very emotional moment for the pride of the country as well as the joy for the boxer.
I was just about to criticise the American for being too intent and looking for the knockout so early, because he's more experienced and had a better technique than the Korean, but he wasn't using any of those. He just seemed to be moving in and trying to bomb him out. Maybe he felt that the only way he was going to get a decision here was to win by knockout. But just as those thoughts were going through my mind, he landed the big punches and finished it. So a lovely performance. He's obviously delighted. A gold medal, and if he does decide to turn professional, then he'll be making good money straight away, won't he, Reg?
Well, that was a nice touch there by the American. He ran over to the Korean's corner, put his arms around him, and did a bit of flashy stuff for the American coverage into the camera. Real professional touch that, but you just cannot deny that one punch on the chin cancels out all the bother of the judges' decisions, and he's making him bow with him all the way round there. He's quite an actor, isn't he, Ray Mercer? And they're playing that theme song that we're really getting brainwashed now by that, but it's a great moment, isn't it, for Ray Mercer and the music at the Olympic Games. And, well, I hope you'll join us for more blood and thunder tomorrow morning in the Olympic finals, the second session. So it's back to the studio.